That's odd, Chris. Assist with an incident that occurred overnight near Lewis. Report came in of a landslide near one of the tunnels. Engineers are already on site, and this train's been arranged to assist with the cleanup. Are you there, Citrus? Are you watching? Alright, let's do this one first. We've got to get the brakes enabled on this one first. Otherwise, the train starts rolling away during the brake tests. So, select. No. Brake cut out. Cut the brakes in. That's it. See you later, Chris. Pop that in run, put the controller in. Again, we got a brake cut out and cut in these brakes. And then we try releasing them. Yeah, it's a top and tail service crucible. Cut the brakes back out again and pop the reverser out, which means the brakes will come back on. That one and where's DSD? That one. Right, day lights, instrument lights, don't want the desk light on. That's cut in. Put those on, put that in, release that. Come out that. I should now be able to release the brakes. Equalising raises at 5, and the pipes just got up to 5. Airflow is returning, brake cylinders are coming off. Put some amps on. Take just a minute for the rest of the train to release, and we're rolling. Signals this ground signal. So we're at Lover's Walk Depot now. That's Lover's Walk over on the right, and we're just driving south into Brighton Station, where we'll do change in procedure. All right, Chris, yeah, send me a video link, definitely. One good tip is if you're messing about with brakes and things, once you've got the train moving a few miles an hour, try cutting the power and make sure that it rolls. Because if you've got any of the brakes wrong, like the rear loco's trying to force apply the brakes all the time, then you'll come to a stop. Neutral. Cut the brakes out. Operate the other cab just to be difficult. Pop in this cab first. And operate the tail lights in there. Hopefully now we've got tail lights. Yay! Hang on a minute. That's probably going to end badly. Shouldn't matter, but we'll turn them off anyway. Just to avoid shenanigans. One and a half should be fine, car going. Somewhere between 1.5 and 2 should do it fine. DSD and AWS. Did we cut the brakes in? Cut brakes in. How are we doing? Got a signal? Let's do it then. Hey, Indirect Web. Just got TSW today with Lear Transpennine MSB. Looking forward to getting into trains. Good on ya. Let's get some lights going. Turn the desk light off. Crikey, why are you not moving? It's rolling. It's being difficult, I guess. Right, we are now bound across the East Coastway. Remember, you can use the speed set function as well, Cargan. Slow speed control, which will help you do that the loading task. What platform is that on Indirect Web? Is that Steam or one of the consoles? Xbox, nice. Gouger! 38 months! How's it going? Thank you for that resub, much appreciated. That's better. Get 45 mile per hour shortly. Someone's alarm is going off. Yeah, it's good. There's a bug where it doesn't change the tail light, so it's got a an external light hanging on the front. It's on the team's list to look at. One tip for newbies: do all the tutorials in Direct Web. Do the root intro tutorials, then do the tutorials. If you just do the journey stuff and follow it through, that's sort of in a reasonably sensible order, that you'll do tutorials, then practice with the trains, then do one more tutorials and practice with the trains. Don't skip the tutorials. Three point 6 miles. Baked Bean Kid, thank you very much for the cheers. Much appreciated. Get a round of GGs for Baked Bean Kid. Two point 9 miles. What did Baked Bean Kid do? He was awesome. Massive cheer. Basically, he's paying his pun dues. Must be Falma. Yeah, it's got to be set up in the service to do that, and it's a scenario, and it's a bug at the moment, B. Harrison. No, I'm going to do the rail tour next, I think. 822? Yeah, rail tour's next. Right, 1.6. Essentially, we have to stop at the outer edge of the possession, and then we get permission to proceed into the possession. What were we ground for loco for the rail tour? Was it 37? Hey, bad guy. How's it going? Gently slowing down, running 3/4 of a mile away now. 480 yards, almost there. Gotta be careful because we're doing a 1 in 88 gradient here. So if you're not careful with the brakes, then you'll find it difficult to stop. Proceed up to the landslide. Proceed at 15. We've only got a mile to go. Just wanted to lift. No, we can stay in the rain. Looks like everyone's enjoying it. Has anyone seen what the Steam review score is? What's that doing at the moment? There won't be much, I dare say, showing up at the minute, but one would hope it's all positive, but you never know. Have I heard any bad reviews through? No, I've not heard any bad reviews at all. But I've really not been looking at a lot of things. I did watch Squirrel's video earlier on. Hundred percent positive at the moment on Steam. Excellent. So already up to 16 reviews. Wow. Well, folks, don't forget to add your review to it if you've got something to say. It all helps. And the team like reading the reviews on Steam, to be honest. Even the bad ones, but don't let that encourage you. Yeah, there was a bunch of stuff that wasn't quite right in that video, unfortunately, Risenball. It said the MyTrack screen wasn't working, didn't know how to turn AWS on. It said there were six scenarios, and then it went to Hastings. But, yeah, it's a pre-release. I'll talk to the publishing team about what we can do to help early access people so that they've got the right information. Oopsie. Job done. Top and tailed, achievement earned, and we got gold medal. I think that scenario works.